Hello everyone and welcome to the channel. My name is Eran and today I have a special guest with me, Liran Tabib, who is the face behind Video DNA. Hello Liran, how are you?
Hi Eran, thank you for having me. It's a pleasure to be here. And I have to say my slogan. You know my slogan? Welcome to Video DNA, where the English is bad and tutorials are good. And this is the most I'm going to speak English today.
So today we're going to see a free script, which is a result of both of us. I did some of the design, but Liran did most of the heavy lifting and coded for us. And this script will help you to create parallax animation automatically inside After Effects. We're going to start with a simple demo. I'll show you how to do it. And then we're going to show you a few other examples of how to use the script. So I'll start here in Illustrator, where I have this multi-layered document file. Now, it's very important to notice the layers order. The furthest layer should be the last one in the list. So in my case, this is the background layer. And the one that I want to be the closest to the camera should be the first in the stack. So in this case, this is the title. Once you design your document inside Illustrator or Photoshop in this order, you will get the most out of this script. So I'll switch to After Effects, where I already have this layer imported as a flattened layer here in the project panel. And I can right click on it and choose replace footage with layered comp. And After Effects is going to convert it to a composition. I'll double click to show it to you over here. It looks exactly the same. And if we're going to take a look at the composition settings, you can see that this is a HD comp and the duration is set to 5 seconds. I'll click OK, and then to show you the challenge, I'll select all the layers and convert them to 3D. Now let's say that for the sake of this demonstration, I want to change the position of the moon. Maybe I want to send it back or maybe drag it to be closer to us. Whatever I'll do, I'm going to change the design. It will be even clearer to understand if I'll switch from one view to two views. Notice that my left view here is the orthogonal top view. And then I'll do the same thing. I'll take the moon layer, I'll drag it on its Z-axis, and you can see what I'm doing here and how this is being translated from the camera perspective. All right, so I'll undo this, and then I'll select all the layers, and just to show you that the layers doesn't even need to be 3D layers. So I'm just going to convert them back to 2D layers, and I don't even need to select all the layers. What I will need to do is, of course, install the script. So I already did it on my machine. You can download the free script from the description underneath this video. And once you install it, you will find it under the window menu. And it's over here, one click parallax. So I'll open it up. As you can see, it comes as a floating panel. So feel free to dock it inside the After Effects interface. And then all I need to do is just click on this button. And this is going to convert all the layers to 3D layers, as well as create a parallax camera for us. It's also switched us back to the two views, so I can click to select the top view, and then I can tap a few times on the comma key, and this is just going to show us how the scene is built up. This is the parallax camera that the script has created for us, and all the layers are being separated in equal distance from each other in 3D space. So let's switch back to one view, and then I'll make sure nothing is selected, and then I'll click and hold on the digit 1 in the main keyboard, and this is going to switch me temporarily to the orbit camera tool. And now if I'll click somewhere and move my mouse left or right, we can get a sense of how this is working. All right, I let go, and then I'll click and hold on the digit 2, which is going to show me the pan under the cursor tool, and it's going to allow you to move like this. And already you can see how this parallax is working. I'll undo, and now I'll click and hold 3, and this is going to, of course, switch us to the dolly tool. So we can use all of these tools to animate the camera very easily and quickly. I'll go to the end of the timeline, and then I'll open up the parallax camera. I usually start by creating keyframes for the point of interest and the position. And then I'll go to the beginning of the timeline. Again, click and hold on the digit 3. And with the latest versions of After Effects, if you click on one of the layers, it's actually going to use this as an anchor point. So I can zoom exactly, or dolly in my case, to the place that I want. Now I can also tap the digit 2 and just bring this guy to more or less the middle of the scene. Then I can select both of those keyframes, press F9 to create an easy ease animation, maybe take those keyframes a little bit before the end, and then press spacebar to preview the quickest parallax animation you ever created in your life. And these are the basics of how to work with the one-click parallax script. Now, if you want, you can take it further, of course, and you can animate the other layers here, as well as give some life to this wolf, for example, or maybe even create a 3D version of this title. And this is exactly what I did in this Cry Wolf Final Comp. So I'll double click to open it, and I'll maximize the frame here. This also has some audio, so let's play it to see how this looks. And these are the basics of the one-click parallax script.
Okay, Ram, that was great. I want to show you all the other features. I want to show you the buttons and what does the parallax amount means. Okay, so let's jump into my screen and see how all of this works. Okay, so first of all, I want to start with this example when you pull out the camera through a lot of leaves. Well, how can we achieve that? Okay, so let's go to the beginning. So we have a lot of leaf layers that together create a text. And we made it in Photoshop, or it doesn't matter how you achieve that, because what's important is this panel. But before I go to the advanced details of the one-click parallax panel, I want to show you these two buttons. So first of all, when I'm gonna click any of the buttons below, you can get into my site or into your site, Iran, which is pretty cool. So come and pay us a visit. And now to the panel. So we can see here that we have a lot of layers, I think 100 layers. And once I'm gonna click this button, the magic will happen. So we have 3D layers, we have a camera, and if we rotate around its axis, we can see that the layers were spread between each other. So how does that happen and how can we control it? So I'm gonna undo this twice and let's talk about the parallax amount. The parallax amount sets the distance between the layers and the default is 50%. But if I reduce that to 10% and press the button again, now we can see that the layers have moved not further apart, but closer to each other compared to 50%. And on this example, I'm gonna take it down to 2%. We'll just remember to undo the parallax. I'm gonna press the create parallax button again. And now I have the perfect distance between the layers to create the animation that I want. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna create some keyframes on the position and on the point of interest. And I'm gonna drag it a few seconds to where I want the animation of the camera to stop. And then I'm gonna go forward to the position I want to start with. And that's about it. We can make it nicer if we're gonna make some easy ease, or maybe add some rotation, Z rotation, of course. So let's go to the beginning and do this. And let's not forget to do some easy ease over here. And we have this great parallax effect. But there is one more thing that we need to cover. And that's, what if you want to use your own camera? So I'm just gonna undo all the changes I did. And now I want to create a new camera. So I'm gonna create a camera. And if I like the 15 millimeters preset or the 200 millimeter preset, it doesn't really matter. But you need to remember that one-click parallax creates the default camera of After Effects, which is 50 millimeters. So if you like another camera, you can create it, select it, and then press on the create parallax button. And now, instead of creating a new camera, it will use the camera that was selected to achieve the parallax effect. So that's all I wanted to show you. And back to you, Eran.
Wow, this was really impressive. And I have a last example for you. We are going to see how to bring a Photoshop file which is bigger than HD. Maybe if you want to scale it down or use more pixels so you can get a little bit more closer to those layers, as well as show you another very cool thing that you can do with this script, which is faux 3D titles. Let's see how this works. So we're going to start here with this Photoshop multi-layered file that I've already imported to After Effects and created a comp out of it. Now notice this is an Ultra HD comp. The reason that I'm working with bigger than HD is because in this case we are talking about pixels. In the previous example that I showed you with the vector art, if you want to scale up a layer, we can always use the continuously rasterized switch, and this is going to make sure that the layer will stay nice and crisp. But in this case, if you want to get really closer to, let's say, this point inside the frame, we need to compensate by creating a bigger image. So the first thing that I'll do here is go to the composition menu and choose composition settings, and I'm just going to switch it to HD. Then I'll click OK. This is still a 5 seconds long comp, and then I'll select all the layers over here. I'll take the parent peak width and make sure all the layers are connected temporarily to this magazine layer. Then I'll press S and I'll scale this layer to 50% and maybe also move everything down just a touch. Now I can select all the layers which has this parenting relationship, hold down the command key here on the Mac control on Windows and click again on the peak width icon, and this is going to dismiss the parenting connection. This is an optional step, but it's a safe way to go. All right, now I'll click outside, and then coming to the script again, I'll change this time the parallax amount to 100, so we'll have greater distance between those layers, which means the parallax is going to be more pronounced. And then I'll click on the magic button, create parallax. So now I can already start to check how this looks. So another pro tip is to hold down the Option key here on the Mac. This will be the Alt on Windows. And if you have a 3-button mouse, you can right-click to orbit around the scene, or you can left-click to track inside, or of course you can middle-click if you want to pan up and down, left or right. All right, I'm just going to undo a few of those last steps so I can start with more or less the frame that I want to land on. And then I'll go to, let's say, 4 seconds. Now, I'm also going to select the title that I've created using Adobe Firefly, and I'll go to the layer menu and I'll pre-compose it. I'll make sure to leave all the attributes in the same comp, and I'm going to also open this composition. And over here, I'll press Command D here on the Mac, Control D on the Windows side, and start duplicating this layer. And I want something like 20 copies. So this is it, I have it. And then, of course, I'm going to click again on the Create Parallax, but this time I'll change the parallax amount to 0.1, and then I'll click on the button. So it looks like nothing is happening because all the layers are very close to each other. But if I'll close this composition and go back to my main comp and then click the collapse transformation button and press S to see the scale, and then let's disconnect the constraint proportions, click and hold on the Z scale, and with the shift key pressed, I can just move a little bit faster and show you that I can scale those layers only on the Z axis, creating these very impressive duplicated copies, one above the other. All right, I'll undo this and I'll start with a value of 5. Then I'll create a keyframe for the scale here in this point. I'll also press Shift P and create a keyframe for the position for this layer. And then I'll select the parallax camera, right click on it, and this time I'm going to work with a null object. So I'll create an orbit null, which create an invisible object in the middle of this comp, and the camera is parented to it. So this almost acts like a gimbal or a crane. So I'll press P and maybe also Shift R to see the position and the rotation. And I'll create a keyframe over here at the 4 seconds mark. I'm also going to create keyframes for the rotation values in case I need them. Now let's go to the beginning of the comp. And then first I'm going to start change the scale of the title here. So I'll start to click and drag to the right, holding down shift. And I want to really separate the titles from each other. So let's just type in 20,000. Next, I'll go to the parallax camera orbit null, and I'll move only its Z position, again, while holding down the shift key to move a bit faster. So I'm looking to start somewhere, let's say over here. Again, I'm just going to type in a value here that I know should work nicely, so 12,000. And then I can lower the camera so we can look at something which looks a little bit more interesting, let's say the edge of this mountain. And now, because I want to fly through all of these copies for the 3D title that I've created, I'll change the Y position until I see something interesting. So let's go with something along those lines. I'm also going to tilt the camera. We can try plus 10 or negative 10, just to give it a little bit of an interesting angle. And now I'll switch to Draft 3D. So After Effects is going to use the GPU to preview everything. And I'll create my first preview by just pressing spacebar. All right, I'll go to the end here, select all the keyframes, press F9 to create an easy ease animation. And of course I can continue to work with the position of the layer. Maybe also add an X rotation value over here. And again, I'll press spacebar to preview and see how this looks. And this is it. All the hard work was executed automatically for us thanks to the one-click parallax effect. Now, the beauty of using this method is that those 3D layers are real 3D cards in space, meaning that they are going to react to lights and shadows. And just to show you how this is going to look, if I'm going to put, let's say, additional 5 minutes, I'll open up the Outside Magazine Final Comp, where I've separated this title behind and above the mountain, as well as created few lights in the scene, and I'm casting shadows. So everything is going to work really nicely together. So let's see how this works by maximizing the composition panel and previewing this comp. And this is it.
Okay, that was great, Aran. I didn't know you can do that with the script. And what really interests me is to see what all of you viewers are going to make with it. So go grab it and do something cool of your own.
Yes, thank you so much for joining us. We hope this is going to be a useful tool for you. Thank you so much, Liran. And we're going to see you next time. Take care and goodbye.